Hey yo together and very welcome to the StarCraft 2 Crazy Replays. Today another TVP, this time on Defender's Landing Ladder Edition. In the bottom left hand side, in the blue playing Protoss, it is Ruxus. And he was playing random, very kind guy telling me that he was playing Protoss and he did not lie. I appreciate that very sportsmanship or mannered or however you want to call it, something positive at least. And in the top right hand side, in the red, is me, Alex Usher, as a Terran, of course, as I hardly ever would play something else. Just love this race, Terran. Mwah. And he's scouting, look at that. Very interesting, two debris with the small entrance here as well as the vision blocker here as well. That's so nice. Scouting versus scouting, annoying probe. He could steal the gas, he could tickle my SCV, he could be so annoying. If he wants to, will he be potentially? Nope. Okay. He goes in? Nope. Okay. Ooh, I could have blocked that. That would have been annoying. But now I see double gas, which already should me tell him the Nexus should be a little bit late. And it is, because it should be started already compared to my base. But as it looks like, this opening, for some reason, I don't know, I'm staying on one base so far myself. Very interesting. Wow, that took way too long to react. Still no base out of Raxus. He's going for a Stargate now as well as a Stalker. And I'm going for something else. Very interesting. Still no base. So now I know it's one base play. Uh oh, my SCV might die. Be so careful, oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Oh god. Okay, I'm scouting with another SCV. I do have a Reaper as well, which is scouting. There we go with the base. He's tricking me really hard, to be honest. I'm bunkering up myself and he's expanding. Look at that. So he shouldn't find any damage, however. The longer this goes, the longer I need to identify that he's expanding, the worse it gets. Like, that's not good. Stalker comes up, doesn't see much. Widowmine on the way as well. And there we go, now I see it. Now I know. Oh, wait, what? That's strange. Do I see the Stargate? Yes, I do. And I might get some kills here. This is what I need. I need to get some kills ASAP. The Oracle not killing the Reaper. Where are his Stalker? They're just coming now, but he's losing so many probes unnecessarily. Now he's down quite some probes. Wow, this Reaper got 5 kills. Will he escape? No, so close. But there's the Oracle. And with the Oracle he could deal some damage. I'm heavily supply capped, still no expansion on the way. There we go, now it's just starting. What is he doing? There's a turret, so he knows. Not too good. Oh, stasis ward. Pooh, only trapping 2 SCVs. That could have been worse. Really bad. 21 seconds, no mining, GG. But luckily for me, I did react in time. And Oracle scouting a little bit, being very annoying. As well as with the revelation. Look at how big the revelation is! And it can't be casted with a range of 9, I guess? Or maybe 7 or 8? Looks like 9 to me. Maybe even 10. And only has 50 energy cost. That's. But he goes in, kills 2 SCVs. Whoa! 4 HP Oracle. Lucky, most lucky Oracle alive. Of course it's alive. I mean, most lucky oracle dead wouldn't make any sense, right? Unless being dead would be the most lucky thing for an oracle to be. Huh. There you go. Now think about it. Think about it. Open up your mind for this heavy thought. Three gates so far, Twilight Council coming up. Unbuildable plates are getting killed here. There's a cooling tower, which can be broken down, blocking this path. Which is not too bad, I would say, if you do this. There we go, stupid revelation. Yep. And now he sees a lot. I mean, he sees it. Doesn't he? It's like he has the shades from the adepts in my base, right here. Sees a lot. Knows the mining. What was that? Ah, Void Ray. Very interesting style, Void Rays. I stink, lol. Yeah, I do stink, but luckily you can't smell it. Just kidding. No, what I want to say, the thing is, this is still the old patch. In the new patch, the Void Rays get a 40% debuff on their speed when they activate the prismatic alignment for the duration of 14 seconds. Another revelation. Oracle will survive this one. Marine. With Stim, maybe I would have killed it, but well. Also, charge does only cost 100-100 instead of 200-200. Huge buffs for Protoss and nerfs as well. At least it's opened up some new metagame-changing builds or playstyles. And that's nice. So here we go, big fight, but this is not a fight I should take. A nice focus fight with the Void Rays on the tanks, but this is GG. Why did I fight there? It was so stupid. I mean, look at that. I just lost everything for nothing. That was very bad. My macro is looking very bad. I don't know if I can win this. I mean, how? It's looking very bad. The Oracle's still alive. Could revelate. Revelate? Reveal? Reveal or revelate? It's called revelation. So where does this word come from? Revealing? It could reveal. Yeah, not revelate. Reveal. I think it could reveal. The middle mine would be nice, but no. Rex's decide. It's time to turn down. No. Nope. Turn around. No. Yes. Maybe. Okay. So I'm bunkering hard. The question is, will this be good for me or not? So far, SCV count wise, I'm 15 worker behind almost. Not good at all. Army wise, it's equal, but with the upgrades, I don't know. Not looking too good here. Ah, a drop. This drop could deal maybe some damage. There's still this stupid oracle. Okay. Oh, the Viking. Oh, only patrolling. Maybe the Oracle goes in again. Will reveal some units. There we go. There's the drop. He sees it. But there's nothing there to get killed. I mean. Oh! Everything lives for another day. So now the Nexus is finished and fully operational and fully saturated. Really nice. With the Void Rays, he could have hunted down this Medivac. Medivacs are only 3.5 fast, Void Rays are 3.5 fast, so meh. It could have worked. Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. Not all too bad. To be honest. So here's the thing. I'm moving out very nicely. And it looks like, welp. He doesn't see it. There are no watchtowers on this map, so you need to spread your armies, maybe proxy pylons somewhere. There you go again. Now he doesn't see it, but he knows. He should know, he is in position. But is he ready for this? Yeah, he sees it. Nice photon overcharge, one tank goes down. And now he needs to move all out because of those debris he just killed, and now I can kill everything right here. And this is a really good checkmate move. He can't split his army properly because he decided to kill this cooling tower. Lost every single probe here. Nice drop evac on the base here. Disruption shots coming in. Killing only 3 marines, that's not really much. And this Nexus might fall. Rexus is falling apart here. Viking gets killed, Widowmine gets a nice shot of kills, something. Look at all the probes that- Wow! That's so much damage. With a 1-2 punch. Yeah, the Nexus is gone. Bye bye Nexus. And here we are. Will I be able to escape? Maybe not, that was not the smartest move. But still, this base is toast. Now I can expand. Oh, that was expensive. Yeah, I should have just evac'd here and that's it, but I wanted to be too fancy, which is never a good thing to do. Don't try to be too fancy. Try to be fancy sometimes, but don't be too fancy. Oh! Wrecked. And now the marine is... Oh! The marine blocks the landing. That was a very good stasis ward. The oracle finally dies. But can I hold this upcoming attack? Can be difficult. He has 2-2 against 1-1. Tanks not sieged. The bio not looking too healthy here. And I don't know. I really don't know. Killed something here. Where did I scan? So I know 3 disruptor. That's a lot of damage. 140? 45, wow. Okay, I'm moving out for some reason. I don't know if that's good or not. Ah, okay, I triggered the shield, the guardian shield. But now I'm trying to flank him. Nice force field blocking me off, cutting my army in half. That's the mistake I did. One disruptor goes down. The second one maybe as well. No, not quite yet. Nice flanking maneuver, and those units are trapped. That's how you lose. That's how you lose a game, like playing stupidly. As Elisa pulled off the line, still 1-1 against 2-2. Stim is running out. I might get the disruptor. No, not really. Wow, it's looking very bad here. I don't have anything on his side of the map. He has doubled the army supply of me. Doesn't quite reach the siege tank. Loses one disruptor in the process. The orbital command does not die. But the stalker does. The disruptor shouldn't die here. More medivacs dying. Nice save with the disruptor into the warp prison. But can he attack into here? That's the question. A big warping. He doesn't have the best income, but me neither. Oh wow. This orbital is full of energy. This one as well. This one quite as well. Not looking too bad, and he's muckering up. If he can contain me, and yeah, just do it, that would be nice. So he tries to come up, or maybe not. Twilight Council making it possible for him to go for the Templar Archive, which he's doing right now. So potential storm, or maybe Archons. Archons, he has so much gas. There we go with the Mule Hammer. Big mule hammer, but I'm only on 5 barracks so far, so I need to get more. I'm going up to 6, want to go up to 8. I'm moving out now, while his army is still up there. And right when I move out, he's attacking. Okay, I'm splitting my army into 2 halves. And a base trade, hello. There we go. Yeah, this liberator will never get finished, this barracks will never get finished. Those liberator might get finished. I don't know if he can do something here. Lol. Okay. I still try my best here to defend, but it's not really happening. Still no drops here. And my main base is dead. I'm now unloading. His adapts are idle. What noob game is this? I mean, I played not really good here. I'm behind in army supply. I'm behind in worker supply. No, actually, I'm a little bit ahead. But, it's 2-2 against 2-2. He's shading right into this, not attacking. He tries to evac the adapts. Two of them might get killed. Or maybe not! Wow, 1 HP adept. Luckiest adept alive. There are his probes. Evac them. He might... Yeah. Oh, the turret! Okay, that was unnecessary. Okay. Wow, okay. So this game just was turned around completely on its head. Wow, or maybe flipped. Not turn around slowly, but flipped like BAM! That's a meaning, right? That's a saying. Flipping the table? Yeah, flipping the game. That's what happened right here. The game was so hard flipped. Okay, so 7 barracks finishing up. Or maybe just 6 of 7. Which is still good. Bunkering up, good. Getting turrets as long as I do have the E-base. But I don't know that there's only one void ray left. There are some SCVs. There are some minerals here. SCVs trying to kill a Nexus. Also very interesting. Oh, there's a War Prism. Look at that. Hello, War Prism. I think it's looking bad for Axis the longer this game goes on. Yeah, 2 orbitals against 1 Nexus. He can't mine. He doesn't have money for another Nexus himself. The unit shows, yeah. Army-wise, he could maybe win. But I do have Liberator tanks, Medivacs and Bunker finishing up. Can he attack into this? Can he do it? Or maybe not. More SCVs. Now I have mining again, which is good. And I'm producing 1 marine. There we go. 1 single marine. Maybe 1 marine soon. He should split the adapt, which he's trying. Oh no! The war prison with the disruptor dies. That's a big mistake. Otherwise, he would have had a good chance of winning this. But now. Oh, that was so expensive. I think he had 2 disruptor there. But now it's GG. That's game. And with that said, thank you so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. As always, I wish you a very nice day and goodbye. Heyo there, thank you for watching. If you'd like to support me, simply hit the thumbs up button. Do you have any wishes, feedback or suggestions, put them into the comments below. You may also subscribe if you're new to the channel. I wish you a wonderful and stress-free day. Take care. Bye-bye.